Hello students, welcome to MS Classes. Today we will discuss drift velocity. If we take a conductor which is not connected with the battery, so you can see that the electrons are moving in a zigzag manner so that their average thermal velocity is zero. Here U1, U2 and UN, these are the initial thermal speed of the electrons, and N is the total number of electrons. If we connect this conductor with the battery and a key, so here this acquires positive and negative. So the electron starts drifting from negative to positive. So now the average velocity with which the electrons gets drifted from negative terminal to positive terminal under the influence of a battery is called drift velocity. So if you see the first electron, speed is V1 vector, that is U1 plus A vector into tau1, where tau is the relaxation time, which is the time lapse between the two successive collision. For the second electron, we can write it as U2 plus A vector into tau2, and similarly for nth electron, this will be U2 vector plus A vector into tau n. So A is the acceleration with which the electrons gets drifted, which is opposite to that of the motion of the electron. Now the drift velocity is the average of all the velocities with which the electrons gets drifted towards the positive end of the conductor. So V1 is U1 plus A vector into tau1. Similarly, Vn is Un plus A vector into tau n divided by n. So if we write this separately, we get U1 plus Un upon n plus A vector common tau1 plus tau n upon n. Now this we have just shown, that average initial thermal speed, which is zero, and this is the average relaxation time. So we can write the drift velocity as A vector into tau average. Now as we know, force, that is mass into acceleration, which is minus E into capital E, because the force is equal to Q into electric field vector. Here Q is the minus E, the charge on electron. So we can write A as minus EE vector upon N. So if we put this value here, we get drift velocity as minus EE vector into tau average upon M. Or if we write without vector, we can write VD as EE tau by M. So here you can see that the drift velocity is directly proportional to the external electric field applied. So more is the electric field means more is the average velocity. So this is our required expression. I hope this topic is clear to you all. Thank you.